Hello, dear friends. We have the honor to have Dr. Toshi with us. Rank AIIMS rank 41, PGI rank is 261. He's our test and discussion student. So on the behalf of DAMS family, we congrats you
Thank
for
you.
Getting such a nice rank in Central Institutes. And we want to share your experience with DAMS family. You have joined our test and discussion in 2017, and now you have joined our AIIMS discussion. So what was your success journey and how you proceed for getting such a nice, awesome rank?
Well, I started, I have been studying regularly during my MBBS time, and I tried to like cover majority of the syllabus during my MBBS, but after seeing the previous questions, I could see that that was not enough.
Okay.
So I opted for the DAMS TND last year during my internship so that I could come into the groove of what is being asked, how I have to attempt the exams. And so basically, whenever we study a subject, there are a lot of lacunas and a lot of voids, and they need to be filled because the question is asked from that small concept, and they repeatedly ask that same question again and again. So I joined DAMS so that every subject I could know what are the important topics, what are the high yielding point key areas which I have to go through, and so that was my strategy to.
So how you used to proceed for test and discussion? How you want used to take the best advantage of test and discussion? Like the first test, say example, you are attempting for the PSM. So from where you get the theory and how you manage to attempt these MCQs and how seriously you used to attempt these MCQs of TND.
For PSM, like I referred to
any
my
subject. Like if you appear for any subject, so what was your strategy? You used to prepare the whole subject, and from where you used to prepare those subject, like your test and discussion. So which notes you follow?
During my MBBS, I had prepared some notes of my own for almost every subject, and these notes mainly had the summary of a topic which I had spent studying for a day or two. See, my aim during MBBS was that if I'm spending 2 or 3 days for a topic, at the end of the day, I should be able to revise it in 2 to 3 hours.
Okay. Yeah. So you used to concise the topic.
Yes. So I used to concise them. I used to either make a separate notebook, or I used to just stick those pages into my core book.
Okay.
So like for example, let's take example of anatomy. I used the Gray's book, Gray's Anatomy Students Edition. I put pages of some conclusion, something I had studied, something I had understood. And then before the TND, my aim was to finish
the whole subject.
Not the whole subject as much as I could, but that should be 100%.
Okay.
So if I'm able to do only 30% of the anatomy, but that 30% should be done.
Then.
And after attending the TND, after going through those questions, I would see that out of that 30%, how well I have performed.
Perfect.
It doesn't matter that I don't know everything of the TND, okay, I haven't been able to study that. But out of that 30%, if I'm able to score 90%, it's enough.
It's a success.
And now
yeah.
I'll work on the rest of the 70% of the course and try to finish it up.
So how do you used to add all these points which our faculties covered in the test and discussion in your hardcore notes which you had made it during MBBS?
Well, I kept A4 size sheets
okay.
with me during the test and discussions, and for every topic I used to use a different A4 size sheet.
Okay.
So I had like 100 sheets by the end of the test and discussion, 100 topics, and those 100 sheets went into my book.
Okay.
And the plus point after that was that when I'm revising anatomy, these 100 sheets, I know where they are stuck in my Grace book, so I can go through that anatomy notes and at the same time see the diagram on that page.
Okay. Now, what was the quality of MCQs? Like you appeared for AIIMS and your rank is 41 in such a nice, awesome rank in Central Institute examination. So what was the role of TND questions? If you compare the questions given in the TND with the AIIMS question.
Well, TND questions were a complete package of questions. There were 30-40% easy questions, 30% difficult questions, and the medium questions. So it was, the TND was aimed at making us study those important topics. So TND, after doing TND, if I was able to finish the entire syllabus of TND after 3 to 4 days of TND, almost 90% of the subject was done.
Means all these topics which were important for AIIMS, what you feel after getting rank, were covered in the test and discussion, it was a complete package for you?
Yes. And one thing which I would like to focus on was that I did the previous year questions.
How many years?
Last 3 years.
Minimum 3 years.
And then if I like a subject, I will just go even back last 4 years, 5 years, 6 years.
Okay.
But if I was able to, I've made sure that last 3 years, AIIMS questions. I had seen them. I had identified that these questions, these topics are being asked repetitively every year or two. So I would make sure that these topics are covered, because they repeat the topics, not the question, but they do repeat the topics.
Repeat the topics. AIIMS, yeah. Beauty of AIIMS MCQs, they definitely repeat all the important topics.
Yes.
And how many times revision? If we come on the revision and what you are considering more on the high-yielding topics. So if we divide the subjects into segment, one is a routine topics, one is a high-yielding topics. So how many times you revise and where you concentrate more?
The high-yielding topics, there's no upper limit, there's no lower limit. If you are able to remember all the glycogen storage disorders in one go, it's enough. If you need 15 revisions, you have to do 15 revisions. Because this time also there was a question, last time also there was a question, last time also there was a question. And for the rest of the syllabus, 2 to 3 times revision is enough. But that is for me. Someone might need 6 revisions, someone might just need 1 revision.
And high-yielding topics, how many times you revise those high-yielding topics?
High-yielding topics, like whenever I was going through biochemistry, I made sure that I'm going through glycogen storage disorders once.
Again,
because
okay.
I have a tendency to forget stuff. So I'll just go through that once and move on.
So you must have attended all our AIIMS mop-up sessions and all those. What is the role of those sessions, satellite special sessions, in getting this rank?
Mop-up sessions were very important, especially this AIIMS mop-up session for 2 days, which happened just before the AIIMS exam.
Yeah.
Because gynae, ma'am covered primary amenorrhea, secondary amenorrhea, and one question was there from that. In surgery, sir made sure to go through emergency of surgery, emergency, and
so these topics were there in your AIIMS examination, yeah?
Yes, these topics were there, and because everything was covered, I wasn't scared about that topic here. So if they ask something from emergency surgery, I will be able to answer it.
Great. Now, before this last year, you must have attended DVT, DAMS Visual Treat, which we conduct for 3 days, consecutive days. What was that motivation? Was it motivation for you to concise all the topics, and what is the role of DVT in your success?
Most important role of DVT was that these were the key topics, these were the high yielding topics which have to be finished. For example, in pathology, sir went through Newborn's chamber, he went through all those RBC indices, iron deficiency anemia, how to differentiate between all the anemias. So these were all the high yielding topics, and I made sure that the topics which have been
should not be missed out.
That should not be missed out.
Then you appear for CBT examination.
Yes.
Last year,
yes,
CBT exam, then your AIIMS mock exam. What was the role of these exam before your AIIMS?
AIIMS mock exam, for me, the main role of that exam was to test my preparation.
Yeah.
See, I don't believe in competition, truthfully speaking. I believe that I'll do my best. Others should also do their best.
Great.
Usko jahan milna hoga mil jayega.
Bilkul. So when you appear for the AIIMS, what was your rank in AIIMS mock?
In AIIMS mock, my rank was 11.
Okay.
But I was not looking at my rank, I was looking at what is the percentage of questions I've done right. Because in any exam, if you do 70 to 75% questions, you are assured to get a seat. So I just saw that I got like 60, 65% questions right. And so I need to improve those 10% more. And I'll get a seat.
So AIIMS rank 11, and this AIIMS you appeared, you get rank 41.
Yes, sir.
So how you compare the MCQs of AIIMS mock against AIIMS examination?
Very similar. AIIMS asks those questions in which there's a small concept, and then the options are really simple. And all the AIIMS mock exam had almost similar questions.
Similar
questions. So I felt that it is almost similar to AIIMS exam.
How was the journey for AIIMS discussion? Like, you again join us AIIMS test and discussion. So what was the experience with the AIIMS test and discussion? Can you just elaborate?
Yes, sir. So in my internship, when I was joined the TND, I wasn't able to complete all the subjects. I hardly was able to complete 50% of the subjects because of the hectic internship at MAMC and everything. So in this 4 months, I made sure that first 2 year subjects are covered properly. I made sure that the initial subjects, anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, microbiology, pharmacology, I'm doing that properly. And my entire focus on was finishing these 2 years subjects. And so my simple plan was to finish as much as I can before going for the AIIMS exam, TND, and then finishing those topics as and when I get the time.
Now, coming on the Exquisite Club, on the Facebook, you must be using the Exquisite Club. What was the role of DAMS Exquisite Club in getting such a nice rank?
Updates, definite help was the new updates which were coming, and much more help was the images which were being posted by the faculty. Especially Diksha ma'am and Surya sir.
Microbiology patho. All these images which they updated in the exclusive club, did they play the role in AIIMS? Because AIIMS is your image-based examination. Yes. They are asking more images. So what was the role of those images which we are updating in the exclusive club?
See, during my preparation, I made sure that I'm going through the images only from the core books.
Mm-hmm.
Because like when I'm preparing for pathology, I made sure that I'm going through the pathology images. But the important thing which happened through DAMS exclusive club was that they were focusing on the high-yielding images or high-yielding topics. So if they put a image of a WBC which has a malignancy, so I know that this is what I have to focus more.
Now, coming on, on this platform, if I ask you, beta, which are the three important subjects or which subjects played an important role in getting such an awesome rank? Which subjects you will choose?
First 2 year subjects, I'll choose them definitely because they are the ones who decide if are you getting selected or not. And after that, other subjects are for getting good rank.
Good rank. Okay. First and second year, yes, are the whether you are in the merit list or you are outside.
Yes.
And the remaining subjects, you will be saying rank deciding topics. Yes. Yeah. So now coming on the DAMS family, which faculties motivate you maximum, or if you want to give some special words for any faculty?
All of them have been brilliant, and but especially Dr. Arvind. And like the one thing which I learned from the faculty the most was that in the exam you won't know everything. You will know just 60-70% of the stuff.
Absolutely.
And what you have to learn by giving these exams, by going through mock exams, is that how you are able to solve with the limited knowledge you have those questions. So they taught us how to rule out options, how to, if you just know one thing about the topic, how to focus on that and get to the answer.
That is more than enough. Yeah.
Absolutely.
So now you, as an intern, you are getting such a nice rank. We congrats you for such a great success. As a MMC student, you are from a prime institute, and now you are going again for post graduation from such a nice institute of AIIMS. Any special message you want to share with your juniors across the country?
One thing which I want everyone to like know is that just before my AIIMS rank was out, I was like terrified, mortified by what will happen. And
you are giving very genuine, honest opinion.
So what I had decided that day for myself was that I gave my best shot. This was my best attempt. If I don't qualify, I know that I need to prepare more. And if I get a seat, whatever I get,
you deserve it.
That is what I get. So because in everyone's journey to get a PG seat, there is a time when you feel low, you feel ki like humse to nahi hoga.
Ye point everybody must be feeling ki yeah, humse nahi hoga. Ye cheez, ye feel aapke man mein aaya, it means it is obvious, common.
Yes.
For everybody.
Yes, sir.
So how you used to manage to this low phase?
So my main focus was that I have to give my best. If I'm able to, at the end of the day, I should not regret that this was not my best attempt.
Yes.
If I know that which was the true case in this time, that this was my genuinely best attempt till now, since my UG days, I'll say.
Okay.
Even the best attempt from my MBBS preparation. So
this was the best.
So whatever I get, I won't regret it.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for such nice opinion, honest advice to your juniors. We wish you very best of luck, and thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.